Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, Justinus Kicks. Hope everybody's out there having a blessed day. As you can see in front of you, I have another review, another Jordan. As you can see, his Airness in gold on top of the box. On the other side of the box is the information. You have Air Jordan 1 Low SE, white and metallic gold. 11.5, my size. And the amount that it costs is $110. Like Skip Gohar would say, 110 good dollars. So anyway, let me pop open the lid. You have your typical white paper with the number 23 in gold, okay? And right here, you have the Air Jordan 1 SE spades. So let me set this to the side. Let me set this one to the side. And let's talk about it. Hey, yeah, my wife is funny. Anyway, okay, so the Air Jordan 1 Low SE spades take the inspiration from a card game that has long been popular among the NBA athletes. Reminiscent of the back of the player's card, an embroidered paisley print is applied to a crimson color quarter panel and toe wrap. Contrasting white leather is utilized on the toe box, eye stay, collar, and heel. The lateral accent with the embroidered wing logo, a shiny gold metallic swoosh, is matched by an embroidered K and Q on the lateral forefoot of the left and right shoe. A spade icon on the woven tongue tag completes the player's card homage. So, as you can see, the details I had just explained, you have here wrapped around your toe box, lateral side, medial side, all the way back to the back of the shoe is your embossed in crimson leather, which mimics the back of players' cards. On the left foot right here, you have the K in gold. You have the Nike gold swoosh and also in a gold metallic. His Airness in the back that's embroidered. On the top of the tongue, as I explained, is your red tag, which has a Air Jordan symbol in white on the spade. White shoestrings laced all the way down. You have a nylon material right here on the tongue. On the inside of the shoe itself, the insole is red with Michael Jordan symbol in white. Around the collar of the shoe, it's a nice padded material, which is a nice fabric padded material, very soft to the ankle. If I failed to mention, the tongue is also wrapped around a nice nylon red color. Toe box leather material. It's pretty nice leather, very stiff leather, so you will get creases in the shoes. On the medial side, the crimson embroidered is wrapped around this all the way around from the toe box to the side to the back with your Nike gold swoosh here. The midsole is like an off-white color, as you can see from front to back. And on the bottom of the shoe, you have nothing but all red from top to bottom. The only difference between this shoe and the right shoe is that the Q is on this shoe in gold. So, as I was explaining earlier, one side has a K, the other side has a Q. So, this is a very comfortable shoe. I would say if you plan on getting a pair of these, I would go true to size. Unless you have wide feet, then you might have to try to feel for a half size up. Nothing bad to say about the shoe. I think it's a very cool color. This is like my second pair of lows, and you know, I'm a very high person. I never had the mids, but I'll go with the lows. So, if you like this pair of shoes, you might be able to find these at your local outlet somewhere. Like I say, unfortunately, the prices haven't went down on them. But hey, it is what it is, y'all. But I like it. I don't think you have a power problem liking them yourself. And like, if you got any other questions, just leave a comment below. I'll get back with you as soon as I can and explain anything that you need to know. Other than that, hope everybody out there is being safe, being blessed. Please do me a favor. Leave a thumbs up if you like what I did this video. Give me a thumbs up. And also subscribe. Thank you. Have a good one. Peace.